अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर फाइन एंड विल बी वेटिंग फॉर माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो. एंड द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर स्टडिंग दिस बुक मैथमेटिक्स सिक्स्थ एडिशन और वट एवर एडिशन यू आर स्टडिंग, इट्स देर इज़ नो मच चेंज इन साइड द डिफरेंट एडिशंस. दिस इज़ डी सीरीज़ वन एंड द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स एंड सेवन इन मोस्ट ऑफ द स्कूल्स ऑफ पाकिस्तान आर स्टडिंग दिस बुक. आई नो, आई डोंट नो what is the system of other countries, but many things of algebra are similar in many countries, and the students of other countries can also take guidance from my lessons, but mostly I am trying to guide the students of this book. Today I am again going to chapter number 5 and going to solve a couple of questions from exercise 5D. This is exercise 5D. I have left question number 1 and 2 for yourself, so you must have learned these questions in schools and you will be able to solve them by yourself just by your school lessons. But many times students are confused in school and they are not able to get their teacher well in the classroom environment. So by YouTube videos, I am giving you opportunity to learn in the comfort zone of your home. Without any disturbance, you can repeat the videos, you can watch it twice, even if you did not get my concepts in the first video, first time hearing. So you can play it any number of times, whatever you like. This is the question 2 over 5 12p minus smaller bracket starts 5 plus 2p bracket close and bigger bracket close. Today I will solve this one first of all. Exercise 5d, question number 3. And the question number 3 demands us write down the simplest form for the following. Writing down the simplest form means we have to solve them as till that step from where we cannot go further. We have to solve all the questions, all the parts of this question till that step from where we are not able to perform any further action. So simplest form means to simplify the question as much as possible. Part number B, 2 over 5, 12p minus small bracket start 5 plus 2p and small bracket close, bigger bracket also close. Yesterday I told you in the first part that we have to solve the smaller bracket first of all, and other things will remain as it is. Solving the smaller bracket means that you have to add or subtract the things inside the bracket. But we can see here is 5 and here is 2p. We cannot add 5 with the 2p. If there would be 5p here, then it will be able to add it. Like if it would be like 5p plus 2p, then we will be able to add these like 7p. Since there is no p here, so we cannot add this. So what we have to do then when we are not able to add the things inside the bracket, we just have to remove the bracket and we have to multiply the digit behind the bracket. Yesterday we saw in question number 1 that there was the 1 over 2 behind this small bracket and 1 over 2 gets multiplied inside the bracket, but today there is nothing. Today we can see there is nothing behind the smaller bracket. When there is nothing, then that means invisible 1 is here, and when we have guessed that invisible 1 is here, 1 will be multiplied with the things inside the bracket, and when 1 gets multiplied with the things inside the brackets, 1 does not put any effect on them. I mean to say that things will remain as it is. When one is multiplied with anything, those things remain as it is. 5 will remain 5 and 2p will remain 2p. So we have to write 2 over 5 as it is, because we are going to solve the smaller bracket first of all. Minus will be entered inside the bracket, and when it gets entered inside the bracket, it changes signs inside the bracket. Positive sign will be changed into negative. Here is invisible 1 will be multiplied with this 5 and 2p. When it will be multiplied with this 5 will remain as it is. 1 5 is a 5, and 1 2p times 2p. Now the smaller brackets has been solved. Sorry if my English pronunciation irritates you or my English is poor, but I am trying my best to make understandings in your mind. I am trying my best to come to the levels of the junior students, but I would appreciate if parents and elder brother or sisters sit beside the students to guide them what I am trying to convey. When we have the solved the smaller brackets, now the bigger bracket is no more bigger. It was bigger when there was the smaller. When there is no smaller, then what is the use of its being bigger? So we'll change into smaller. Now we can see 12p and 2p here. Both will be added or subtracted. We will decide it later. They will be added or subtracted. We will decide it later. But first of all, we will put them together. 12p minus 2p and minus 5 will be put aside. 2 over 5. We will subtract 2p from 12p and we will get 10p here and minus 5 here. Why I have written 10p? Because here was the positive sign. Why I am saying here is the positive sign? When there is no sign, that means there is the invisible positive sign. And when we will apply addition or subtraction process in algebra, we use the signs of the bigger value. Not necessarily in algebra, but everywhere we use the sign of the bigger value while applying the addition or subtraction process. Here is 12 the bigger value. It is bigger than 2. We are applying operation between these two things, 12p and 2p. 12 is bigger than 2, so we will use the sign of 12p. Its sign is positive. We will use positive sign here. When I have written nothing here, that's mean positive sign is here. Why I have subtracted 2? Because there was the minus sign here. 12p, 2p will be subtracted from 12p. Only coefficients will be subtracted. P will remain as it is. Coefficients mean here 12 is the coefficient and here 2 is the coefficient. Coefficient will be added or subtracted, but P will remain as it is. Now it's the turn of the 2 over 5 to enter inside the bracket. It will enter like this. 2 over 5 multiplied by 10p. Since my video is getting bigger and bigger, so I will try to sum up the question. Firstly, 2 over 5 will be multiplied by 5. 5 tens are 2, 5 2 times 10, and 2 by 2 4p, and 5 ones are 5, 2 1 times 2. Now we cannot apply further process or action here, because 2 cannot be subtracted from 4p. Thank you very much. Please stay tuned.